Hwa Chong Institution gears up to contest their 10th consecutive gold, and they will meet Raffles Institution this year. Can HCI repeat their undefeatable feat and bring home a clean sheet once again? You are about to witness all the exciting highlights from the National Schools A Division Basketball Competition 2015. Welcome to the National Schools A Division Basketball Competition 2015. For the past 9 years, Hwa Chong Institution has sat firmly on the throne, a feat that no other school has even come close to. Raffles Institution secured a place in the finals when they beat last year's first runner-up, Anderson Junior College, 57-41. But they will have no easy task as they go up against these mighty giants. Will Hwa Chong Institution celebrate their 10th victory tonight? Or will Raffles Institution be the school to deny them of their bragging rights? Let's find out.
This is the National Schools Basketball Championship 2015 A Division Finals. I'm Paco Lopez, and we're here to witness the action from 9-time defending champions, Hwa Chong Institution. HCI struggled to reach this year's championship game by slipping past Nanyang Junior College 59-57 in the semifinals, while RI, led by captain Zaki Ghazali, dominated Anderson Junior College 57-41 in their semifinal. Within seconds, they pounce through HCI's defense to make it 4. Great way to start the match, RI. HCI's Dylan Chua with the throw-in. Another interception by RI. This time it's Joel Ong. Big Nash Rangarajan catching the rebound. And he slots in another. 6-0 to RI. HCI is looking to win their 10th straight A Division title, but RI is threatening to dethrone them. And now with a throw-in, RI is looking to put in their 4th straight basket. Vignesh Rangarajan taking the free throw. HCI, Daryl Lee catches the rebound. HCI is looking for that elusive opening shot. HCI, Yap-Ten Swang with the free throw. HCI finds their opening basket, and they're on the board. And they make it 2. Free throw awarded to HCI. Yap Teng Swan taking the free throw. He converted the last two free throws, and it's another successful conversion. Both teams have put in four baskets each, but RI is leading 8-4. Big Nash with the ball, trying to make some magic and widen their lead. Nice trick there by Big Nash. He fakes the shot, but passes the ball to teammate Jovi. HCI catches the rebound. Oh, Tang Swan loses the ball. Great interception by Vignesh. RI's dominance of the game has left HCI trailing behind 10-4. RI is leading with a 6-point advantage already. RI's defensive efforts have denied HCI's penetration time and time again. Paul Z Kong with the free throw, and it's a point up for HCI. HCI's perfect conversion of their free throws have given them all of their 6 points in this match so far. HCI takes the offensive rebound. It's Tall Z Kong attempting a shot. And oh, a wasted opportunity. Championship titles at stake here for these young men. One is looking for a perfect 10th season, and the other is here to attain the bragging rights for displacing the 9-time defending champions. We went into the match thinking it'll be an easy win for the mighty HCI, but RI has been putting up a very good fight. It's Big Nash once again, shredding through the defense. Close, and RI with the rebound. A loose ball over there. Thank you. It's Engine 10 who put in RI's seventh basket. Quick passes by HCI. But oh, the ball fails to find the net. HCI going for a three-pointer. And once again, HCI loses the possession to RI. Going into the ninth minute of the match, RI's strong passing and swift counterattacks paired with HCI's weak defensive line has enabled RI to score point after point. HCI has just got to strengthen both their offense and defensive play to turn this game around before it's too late. That's the first free throw that HCI is not able to convert. Will they be able to convert the second? And yes, the ball finds the net. So with less than 6 minutes left in the first quarter, the score is 7-14 in favor of RI. With a jump pass to Edgen, who tries for a shot. Great teamwork! Sloppy passing by HCI. Every single mistake is crucial, and it'll cost them the titles. Narrows the gap for HCI. HCI seems to be rejuvenated, and this can be the turning point for the team. And they secure another point. Left on the clock to the end of the first quarter. Defense! the free throw for HCI. The score still remains at 11-16. Surprise and drops in a shot. A brilliant jump shot by HCI Tan Ike. Timeout. We're into the last 2.5 minutes of the quarter. And since the start of this finals, RI has gone on a quick scoring burst, and they seem to have found all the holes in the HCI defense to put in easy shots. It seems like RI is gearing up to be the new kings of the hardwood. HCI setting up. Final 2 minutes of the first quarter. Free throw to RI taken by Ernest Ching. 19-13. RI has got to be content with just a point. Turnaround by RI as they pile on the pressure with a 21-13 lead. Justin's second basket of the match. HCI attempts a three-pointer, but oh, the ball didn't find the net again. And ignites a fast break basket by Justin Yeo. They have opened their largest lead of the game. They're leading by double digits now. Oh, and the defending champions answer the challenge with a basket of their own. looking dangerous. And that's the end of the first quarter. The score now stands at 15-23 in favor of RI. We're into the fifth minute of the second quarter, and the score now stands at 17-27 in favor of RI. Tension is in the air as both teams battle for the ultimate glory. Hwa Chong Institution is looking to complete a 10-year championship run, but RI is giving them a run for their money. Towards the end of the last quarter, HCI rejuvenates their play, but still trails by a wide margin. They have to do more to win the game in their favor. Free throw to RI taken by Qian Xiaoji. And he makes it two. A missed shot by HCI, but Steve Chong has the opportunity to redeem their mistake, and it's 2 points to HCI. Going to be a free throw for RI. The HCI team is coached by former national player Michael Wong. Free throw taken by Justin Yeo, and it's a point to RI. Every shot brings RI closer to clinching the titles and displacing the 9-time defending champions. Interception by RI's Jovi Lim. Qian Xiaoji with the shot, but oh, just off the mark. HCI is awarded the free throw. Can To Si Kong put one in for his team? No, he wasted the opportunity. Let's see if he can redeem himself with this one. Yes, 20-31. RI is not as aggressive compared to the start of the first quarter when they opened the game with relentless scoring. And I've said it too early, Five Fat puts in a surprise basket with a brilliant solo effort. Here's Chan Xiaoji once again, trying to set up another shot. Star player Justin Yeo going for a shot. Oh, that'll be a free throw to R.I. R.I. continues to extend its lead, and HCI has to double their efforts to get back in this game. Left of this quarter before the halftime whistle blows. Justin Yeo is making a beeline for the basket. He's going for a shot. Oh, he missed it. Let's see if he can secure back the 2 points from the free throws. And we've got a substitution for RI. Captain Zaki is replaced by Ejin Tan. Established a 17-point lead, and the halftime whistle has not even blown yet. The seconds are ticking by, and HCI has a rather insurmountable task to overcome. After a drive spell for 6 minutes, HCI finally replies with a shot. HCI going for a three-point shot. R.I. caught the rebound. The heat is is on. HCI is trying to mount some pressure here. Oh, another missed shot. HCI is paying for their sloppy mistakes. Pat with the throw in. HCI is trying to shake off RI's tight defense. They find an unguarded territory and go for a shot. Oh, a wasted chance again. RI's Fifat races down with lightning speed. Oh, but he fails to convert. HCI picks up the game a notch with excellent teamwork. Daryl Lee squandering away the free throw. And he redeems for the second. The halftime mark. Hwa Chong Institution's efforts in the last few minutes have put a dent in Raffle Institution's momentum, but they still face a large deficit heading into the locker room.
I'm enjoying all the action from the first half. It's still anyone's game and the trophy is up for grabs. Watch us crown the A Division champions when we return. Stay with us.
Welcome back. I'm Paco Lopez, and we're watching the National Schools Basketball Championship 2015. In the first half, Raffles Institution has put up a suffocating defense to deny Hwa Chong Institution any hope of leading the game. We're 3 minutes into the final quarter, and RI is leading 63-46. RI's dominance of this game has left HCI trailing way behind. But is their lead great enough to deny a comeback by the 9-time defending champions? What a great attempt! RI is keeping the pressure up for HCI. Chen Xiaoji going up against Tan Ike. Through HCI's defense, and it's 65-48. Oh, wow! And they swiftly follow up with another. This time, a shot by Ejin Tan. HCI tries to get back into the game by sneaking in a shot. They're a lead from HCI. Fat taking the free throw. This is only the second time RI has missed a free throw. The ball still can't find the basket. The score remains at 71-52. HCI's Yap Ten Swan picking up the tempo. Even though they're faced with a 19-point deficit, HCI has not given up. This is excellent sportsmanship on display. results in a long shot for RI, 73-52. HCI's Yap Ting Swan driving the ball forward. That will be a free throw to HCI for obstruction. Shot and he gets a free throw instead. Has scored from most of their free throws. This has further extended their grip on the game. Beautiful shot. You have to admire the spirit of the HCI boys. They have not given up and continue their beautiful play. Timeout. We're now into the final 1.5 minutes. With an 18-point lead, it's obvious now that Raffles Institution will claim their first A-Division championship since 2000. And Hwa Chong Institution will go home with a silver for the first time in the last 9 years. Even though at this stage the results are clear, both teams are still determined to play their finest basketball for the last 1.5 minutes. another timeout. 56 seconds left on the clock. And even though they're faced with defeat, these boys are going to keep on fighting until the end. And this is the kind of spirit that all student athletes should have in the national school games. Never give up. It's not just about the wins. It's about how you play the game. HCI is clear here. They're trying to attempt a series of three-pointers to level up and close the gap. And they got one in! 5 more to go for an equalizer. Is this still attainable? Too late. In another for HCI. Another timeout to re-strategize for the final 30 seconds. Star player Justin Yeo. Although HCI benefited from the free throws led by countless fouls from RI in the third quarter, they couldn't seem to claw themselves back into this game. Their streak of a possible 10th A-Division title will come to an end. It's seconds away before we announce the new Kings of the A-Division Court. thereby spoiling HCI's game plan of multiple three-pointers. In their bid for a 10th straight title, and Raffles Institution is the champion of the 2015 A Division Boys. Congratulations!
The game, we told ourselves, don't put pressure on ourselves or us. I mean, Hwa Chong is 9-time defending champion. The pressure is on them to complete the streak of 10 in a row. So we told ourselves, just play our game, we should be able to win. I would say that there wasn't any defining moment, although they did make some good balls, but our defense kept strong throughout the game. We controlled the pace. I think that's how we won. We just trained hard, we just put in effort at all training, and we just play as a team. Don't fight. And from the start of the season, we put our aim on Hwa Chong. We didn't want anyone to beat Hwa Chong because we want to beat Hwa Chong in the final. When NY almost beat Hwa Chong in the semis, right? We were like, no, this is our time. We have to beat Hwa Chong. It's our job to beat Hwa Chong, not them. Feels good. 9 years in a row, it's no joke. They did well for 9 years, now it's our turn.
It was a well-fought game and kudos to both teams on their best efforts. Congratulations to Raffles Institution on a solid performance and winning the competition. Thank you for staying with us through another edition of the National School Games. We hope to bring you all the exciting action from the school sporting calendar. Like us on our Facebook page at facebook.com/nationalschoolgames so you don't miss any of the action. Or share with us your own journey on the National School Games simply by using the hashtag NSG2015. I'm Mark Das, and I'll see you next time.